With the new Star Wars movie dropping, let's just note that even though we're all Star Wars fans here, there are seismic differences in quality between the various movies. They range from the embarrassingly poor to the timelessly brilliant. So let's have it. I'll give you my personal best to worst list of the existing 8 movies. Empire Strikes Back. The predictable choice. Unless someone has really good arguments for why Empire is not at the top of their list, you know that you're not dealing with a real Star Wars fan. The contours of ancient Greek tragedy are packed into accessible Hollywood entertainment that manages to pull it all off. Pop culture versions of Zen and Taoism abound. And the movie has the sickest plot twist of any movie ever. It is through Empire that the Star Wars story gains depth. Without this movie, it would be unlikely that Star Wars would continue to haunt pop culture the way it does. Even people who do not list Empire as their favourite still owe it a great debt. Few also acknowledge how much of a shift the dark and introspective tone must have been as a follow-up to the more giddy A New Hope. Return of the Jedi. Fans love to rip on it, and indeed it is too long. The setup at the start of the movie, where the friends try to rescue Han from Jabba, should have been shorter and less convoluted. The whole subplot with the shield generator on Endor could have been replaced by the Imperial fleet dropping out of hyperspace, the way the Death Star does in Rogue One. If the plot on Endor had been ditched, the writers would also have more screen time to develop the scenes in the throne room, which are some of the best in all of Star Wars. The space battle is excellent, except for the fact that the Executor goes down to an A-Wing. That's too silly. But in return, the Wagner-esque scene where Palpatine arrives at the Death Star can make even the biggest supporter of democracy want to stretch out his arm in a Roman salute to show just how high the snow was piled back then at Stalingrad. And Vader's redemption is the perfect resolution to the setup that Empire Strikes Back laid down for this movie. A New Hope. It has not aged as well as the other movies, but it's still the best introduction to Star Wars. One thing that the film doesn't get enough credit for is how perfectly each character is introduced. With simple cinematic tools, we get all of the information we need without being talked down to at any time. The immersion scenes at the beginning of this movie, where we get to know the universe and the characters, are the high points of this movie. The end is satisfactory when seen in relation to the film, but largely irrelevant to the wider Star Wars story. That counts as a minus. A New Hope is perhaps the only movie in the franchise that can be seen and understood in full without having seen any of the other movies. It's the tutorial for Star Wars, the 7-note scale you have to master before you can play the instrument. Revenge of the Sith. All of the prequels lack focus. In terms of narrative, this film is a complete mess, and it's easy to get frustrated with the many wasted opportunities and missed chances that abound this movie, both dramatically and cinematically. The Grievous character does not work and should have been cut out. However, all the right themes are present, and it could have been one of the best Star Wars movies if it had have been better carried out. It's the only prequel which tries to convey an existential message that is relevant to the viewer beyond Star Wars. A pop culture and deeply flawed version of Citizen Kane. It tries to be tragic, but it just doesn't work. It's simply too messy and confusing to hit us in the feels. The scene where Anakin marches to the temple and murders children to the sound of the marching music was brilliant though. That excuses the rest of the prequels. Rogue One. Many good scenes, but ultimately quite the mess. A main character without any personality, and who does not do a single thing throughout the film, is not the best protagonist for an action thriller. Too many characters come and go without the audience understanding who they are or why they are relevant to the story. It says a lot about the film's characterization that the most memorable and emotionally relatable character is a robot. The Cinderella-like plot, where the persecuted heroine suddenly discovers that she is extremely important because of her father's love for her, is fine, but doesn't suit the Star Wars universe. The final scene with Vader, however, was worth the price of the movie ticket by itself. Rogue One might have been a better film if it had just been this one scene played 10 times over in a row. The Force Awakens. Immensely entertaining, but the more you think about it, the worse it becomes. That's usually a bad sign. The plot is completely irrelevant to the wider scope of Star Wars, and doesn't further the story in the least. The characters are stale and difficult to relate to. The only character that is hinted to have just a bit of depth is Kylo Ren, who apparently is going through some sort of goth or emo phase. Rey is a horrible protagonist who, just like Jen from Rogue One, doesn't have any personality. Without any explanation given, she is also better than everyone at everything. This is the second reason why the movie fails. The Force Awakens tries to be A New Hope. But where Hope gives a viewer all of the information and background that you need to understand what you are seeing, The Force Awakens makes no sense. Who is Snoke? Who is Rey? And how can the movie be clinically cleansed of all the sexual innuendo that we know from the previous episodes and still be called The Force Awakens? One simply cannot understand it. Phantom Menace was originally at the bottom of my list, and it really isn't good. In fact, it's fatally bad, and should definitely not be seen more than twice in a lifetime, no matter how much of a Star Wars fan you are. However, it does revive the feel of the original movies in a more elegant and subtle way than it's usually given credit for. It's probably the prequel that feels most like one of the originals. The movie is error-ridden and inadequate from start to finish, but it really does contain many good ideas, which, however, the film manages to destroy again before something worthwhile comes from them. People love to hate it, but many probably like it more than they dare to admit. For example, people say that they hate Jar Jar so much, but nevertheless, they do their best to sound like him in the comments on YouTube. Attack of the Clones. The bottom of the barrel for me. Most people would probably prefer to dig out their entrails with a spoon rather than be forced to sit through one of the worst romances in movie history ever again. Any woman who has the misfortune of a guy trying to pick her up with the line, "I don't like sand," is fully justified in writing a social media post about it under the hashtag of #MeToo. The final battle of Geonosis, which should have been the payoff for this insufferable movie, is overdone and looks more like a video game than a movie. In the end, there were so many lightsabers on screen that it felt more like glow sticks at a rave than like Star Wars. It was satisfying to see Christopher Lee beat two Jedis, of course, but there should have been continuity in the choice of antagonist from Phantom Menace to Clones. And Yoda pulls out a lightsaber? No, just no. All of the prequels lack focus and immersion, but this one is clearly the worst.